Today we will discuss basic English grammar. In that we will discuss the topics like alphabets and alphabetical order, words, sentences and phrases. First we will go to alphabet. In English language we have 26 alphabets. Out of that 5 are vowels. They are A, E, I, O, U. 5 vowels. And rest 21 are consonants. We always take the help of vowels to make words out of consonants. For example, if I want to write Friday, I can't make the spelling like this, F-R-T-Y. I need the help of vowels like F-R-I-D-A-Y. Here, two vowels I used. Another example, like I want to write convent, so what I will do? I need vowels to make the word. So it is understood that we need vowels. We need the help of vowels to make words. Now, I hope you understood alphabets. Now we will go to alphabetical order. What is alphabetical order? Alphabetical order. We have a chapter on alphabetical order. The order A, B, C, D, E to Z are called alphabetical order. The fine example of alphabetical order is the class attendance register, where the name of the students are written in alphabetical order, like starting with Amar, then Aditya, one A, single A, then AA, then Abhishek, AB, then we will go to C, Kevin, C after D, Danny, then E. If there is no name, we will leave. If we find a name, we can write Emmanuel. F. Farida. So on. So A. If two A are coming, these two A will come first. If I want to write Deepak. Deepak. I cannot write Deepak here. No, Deepak should come here because after D, we will see the second letter which comes first. A comes first. So, Danny first, then Deepak is the second. This is the correct way of writing alphabetical order. Now, we will go to discuss about word. What is a word? A word is a sound or a letter or a group of sound or group of letters that expresses a particular meaning, that is called a word. And words are always having space on its either side. It means before and after. For example, I is a word with single letter. It is having space before it and after it. So it is a word with single letter. Now you see a. This is also a word with single letter and having space both the sides. Is. This is a word with double letter. Now we will see a word like today. Today is a word which is having space on its either side before and after, and also group of letters which has a particular meaning. The group of letters without particular meaning is not a word, like A, B, C is not a word. B, C, A is also not a word that should have particular meaning. Without meaning, if that is a group of letter or group of sounds or a sound or a letter, that is not a word. So word means that should be group of letters or sometimes a single letter, but should have particular meaning. Without meaning, they are not words. A, B, C or B, C, A or X, Y, Z or I, P, C, they are not words. Now we will come to know more about sentences and phrases. Sentence and phrase. What is the difference between sentence and phrase? A sentence, I am writing one sentence. The teacher is teaching students. This is a sentence. A sentence is a group of words arranged in an order which has, so that it make one complete sense. Here are many words we will see. The is a word, teacher is a word, is teaching the students. Here we find group of words which are arranged in an order that so that it can give a complete sense. But a phrase stand up. This is a phrase. A phrase does not make complete sense. A phrase is has contained two or more words. It does not have subject and verb. It does not give complete sense, but a sentence give complete sense. And a sentence always starts with capital letter and ends with full stop. Sentences are various types. Like we have imperative sentences, interrogative sentences, exclamatory sentences, positive sentences and negative sentences. So I hope you all understood what are alphabets, what is alphabetical order, how we can know a word, that it is a word, find out word, what is word, sentence and phrase, the difference between sentence and phrase. Phrase does not start with capital, no need of putting full stop, but in sentence we should start with capital letter and end with a full stop. The sentence gives complete sense, but stand up does not give a complete sense. So today it's all. Now, thanks for watching.